and choosing for us today the new Pope, number 118, the Coptic Church, Pope Tewodros II, who was chosen today by the grace of God, and he will be ordained as a new Pope to the Church after 2 weeks. We want to thank God for his gift, and we want to congratulate all of you. And we hope that the Church receive a period of peace and righteousness. Second, as you know, today the Church read for us the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter number 7. And this is one of the most famous chapters in the New Testament. We call it the chapter of the compassionate God, or the compassion of God. It started this chapter by how the Lord saved the servant of the centurion, the stranger. And the story today, the day after this, the Lord went into a city called Nain. And many of his disciples went with him, and a large crowd. And when he came near the gate of the city, and this is the key to understand this story, it is not just a story which had happened many years ago, but this is the story of the man everywhere, every place, every time. The Lord came to the city. No one asked the Lord to come, but he by himself, by his will, he visited his people. He, because he is a compassionate God, he came to Nain, knowing that there is a problem with the widow there. The widow there, she lost her only son. And no one asked the Lord to come. When he came near the gate of the city, behold, a dead man was being carried out, the only son of his mother, and she was a widow. Large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said to her, "Do not weep." The fathers of the church, they said many nice things about this story. They said that this widow is Eve, because her husband Adam died when he disobeyed God. And who was that son, the son of the widow? This is everyone, every person in this world. And we, being son and daughter of death, we carry death in our nature. And the Lord, being a compassionate God, he came to our city. He came to our land. And on the gate of the city, he offered himself on the Golgotha, because he is a compassionate God. He offered himself. He wants to save the son of the widow. He wants to save me. No one asked for this. No one can expect that one day the dead man can come rise or can rise again. No one asked for this. But the Lord by himself, being a compassionate God, that is because of his compassion, that is because of his unconditioned love. Because of this only, there is nothing can make God to take our nature and to come to our city except that he is a compassionate God. He came to our city and he saw the widow weeping. And the Holy Scripture said, when he saw the widow weeping, he had compassion on her and said to her, do not weep. And then he came and touched the open coffin. The crowd were amazed because in the Old Testament, the commandment of God, you cannot touch a dead person. If you touch a dead person, you became unclean and you need to go to the temple and to do the commandments of purification. But the Lord by himself, he came and he touched the open coffin. He came and he touched our nature that represents his incarnation. He came and be in direct contact with our death. He took our death to give us his life. He touched the open coffin. He came to our world. He touched our nature. And he said to his mother, do not weep. I have a solution. Do not weep in your problem. There is always an open gate in the heaven. The solution must come from heaven, from God. I know that every one of us, we had many, many problems. We cannot do it, we can solve it. But believe in God. He always have a solution. He came and he touched the open coffin. And those who carried him stood still, and he said, young man, I say to you, arise. He took his death in his divine nature, and he gave him his resurrection, because God is the life. He took our death and gave us his life. He said to him, arise, arise. And he who was dead sat up and began to speak. And all the sorrow, all the suffering changed suddenly into a heavenly joy. So the Lord, after rising the child or the dead man, he presented him to his mother again. And he said to her, I said to you, do not weep. I am here. I am here. Yes, you did not ask me to do anything. You cannot expect that can I do it, but I did it. This is your son. I brought it back again to you. He presented him to his mother. Then fear came upon all, and they glorified God, saying, a great prophet has risen up among us. God has visited his people. God has visited his people. Yes. They prophesied about the Lord Jesus Christ that he is a great prophet. And yes, he is. But he is not only great prophet, but he is God himself. So they said God have visited his people. I just want to summarize what we said. We said that this story is a real story, but also that is my story. I am the dead man and you are the dead man. And the widow is our church who want to have happiness and joy by our resurrection. So the Lord today, he is now in our midst. And he, by his power and by his authority, he will not only touch every one of us. No. He will enter to our inner man. Today, you will not be only touched by the hand of God, but you will receive the body and the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. You will hear from his mouth, my young man, arise. And he wants to represent you again to the church, not as a dead man, but as a living one. To be a source of happiness and joy to the church and to everyone around you. Just to finish, to live the resurrection, we need two things. First, we need the power of God. And we believe that now the Lord by himself, he is now in our midst. And he will touch every one of us. And he will give resurrection to each one of us. And he will say, arise to every one of us. That is the first factor. But the second factor, we must respond. We must believe. We must go from the church after receiving the body of and the blood of the Lord, new creature in Jesus Christ, living creature, having new mind, having new life, having not the life of the dead, but having the life of the living one. So I pray for all of you and for myself that today the Lord can open our ears and to receive his words again. My beloved son, arise. Don't be like this. Arise. I will not only touch you, but I will enter to your inner man. I will give you my body. I will give you my blood. You have no reason to stay like this. I by myself will be with you. Receive the gift of God. Receive the resurrection. Receive eternal life. Eternal life, it is not a time, but it is a person. Eternal life is Jesus Christ, the Son of God. So my brethren, if that our belief, I encourage myself, I encourage all of you to have this time in the liturgy, the coming few minutes, confess your death, confess your sins, and ask the Lord to come and to touch us. Ask the Lord to come and change our sorrow, our suffering into happiness and into joy. Ask the Lord to come by his glory and ask him to give us a special power to respond actively toward his grace. I am praying this for myself and for all of you. And glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever.